part of Lisbon's charm is that it's built uphill, upside a mountain or something like that. But it also means there's a lot of staircases, there's a lot of hills, and there's a lot of walking. Luckily, they have these contraptions that are part escalator or part rail system. And if you're there in time, you can get to take them where you want to go. We're not all that lucky, but I've heard about a restaurant at the top of this hill where the escalator goes. And I want to visit that. The website looks really, really good, so I'm so looking forward to it. It should be worth the trip. But unfortunately, it was closed for renovations. So I'm going back down again to where I started. Like with many other European cities, there's a covered market. But frankly, I'm really hungry after the walk, so before I visit the market, I'm gonna get something to eat. And the first thing I see is a fish restaurant. How perfect is that? And of course, you can choose your own shellfish, but I'm gonna let the cook decide for me exactly which beast I'm gonna eat. There's no doubt in my mind that the best thing I got to eat there was this, a giant grilled tiger shrimp. So I'm gonna show the recipe for that one at the end of this video. But now that I'm satiated and happy, it's time to check out the market. And it's a great place, lots of tables that are shared for all the stalls, and lots of stalls where they sell different specialties. And it's a really big market. And I must say that the thing I miss the most after eating, that's a dessert. Blood sugar is dangerously low. Oh well, nothing that a piece of chocolate cake can't save. And that's really good too. But the struggle for man's survival and food goes on. Despite the sun, the staircases, the hills, lack of water. And I returned to a restaurant I have been to previously, where I tried the lunch menu. And the lunch menu was good, so now I'm gonna try a lot more food. That's the good trick I talked about. I'm gonna try all the starters I can eat. Starting with green eggs that are fried and soft sweet onions. And that's good. Very nice. Then it's time for black-eyed pea salad with braised tuna. That's also good. It's a really good tradition to do this, eating all the starters. Duck eschabe, marinated duck that is fried with potato strips. And that is also very good. I'm getting quite in the mood now. Zucchini creamy soup. It looks very nice. Yeah? No, it tastes like grass. For my sake, they can leave that off the menu, but luckily I can rinse my palate with a little wine. Now it's time for the main, thin pork liver steaks. I normally love pork liver. But this was kind of mediocre. Well, all in all, it's been a very nice visit. Most of the dishes were good. Time for a drink and then back to bed. So I'm ready for tomorrow for another long day of traveling and eating. This is some big tiger shrimps. Sometimes if you got new ingredients that's a bit odd, it can be difficult to know what to do with them, but actually it's really simple to treat these guys, and I'll show you how to grill them, even if you don't have a grill, and they taste fantastic. A lot better than lobster. The shrimp cooks really fast, so I start off with doing the salad and preparing that. Rinse it. It's a good idea to let it rest in the water for a little while so it gets really crisp and flavorful. Make it completely dry. There's nothing worse than a soggy salad, at least when it's soggy from water. I clean it up so it looks nice on the plate. Add some balsamic vinegar, the good stuff. Some coarse salt. And a burratini. This is a cousin of the mozzarella. It's a mozzarella that's got cream and mozzarella leftovers inside. It's absolutely my favorite mozzarella-like cheese. Cut the tomato into bite-sized pieces. Add them to the salad. And then pour on a lot of olive oils. I've added more than you can see here. I added once before, but I forgot to film that. And now it's time for the shrimps. You have to cut them from the bottom, the body first, or the tail, whatever you prefer to call. You can cut it from here, because then you'll have to cut inside the shell or through the shell. That's impossible from that side. Well, without cutting your fingers or anything else it is. So find the middle between the legs. Cut it and press the knife down hard to separate the shell. It's difficult, but it's certainly possible. Turn it over and do the same thing with the head. You see it's full of gunk. You remove that. Oh, that's not white meat. This is the intestines. We don't want that. It's full of shrimp food. Just rinse it very well. You see here I get hold of the intestine, pull it off. Small tiger shrimps has that as well. So, use your thumb. Now time to dry them off. They have to be really dry, otherwise they won't get crisp later. I dry them off with a paper towel. But actually you can use anything for that. Salt. Then I prepare a few garlics. Prepare even. Cut them into large chunks. We don't want them. They have to be fried really hard, so we don't want them to burn. On a very hot pan in some very hot oil. And as soon as they start to brown, we take them up. We only want the flavor in the oil. Then we add the shrimp and see how hot this is. Otherwise, they won't get crispy. They'll just get soggy or chewy. I press them down firmly so they really can absorb the heat from the pan. When they are clearly browned, we turn them over, press them down again. All in all, it's about 1.5 minutes of frying time. I'll show it in the end of this video. There's a complete frying of shrimps, so you can see how long it's actually gonna take. And that's it. As easy as that, it's done. A nice starter, a nice lunch. Enjoy. And here I'm just gonna take a few minutes to show how long it really takes to fry these shrimps without editing the video. Thank you. and you can find the list of ingredients and the recipe on kvalifood.com.